And we're back for game number 3 between Savera TV and No Logic Gaming. The first game was won by No Logic Gaming. The second game, they went for a bit of an iffy draft. At least, not meta related at all. And Savera TV in the end with a nice meta, basic lineup where able to just do it and win the game. Turn it into 1-1. The lineup itself was just really well balanced as well. So, want to also remind everybody, this is the Mount Hermon charity tournament. We are here for the charity called Save the Children, helping out refugee children all over the world. 10 seconds. And yeah, guys, we just want to make everybody aware of that. You can donate to us through our stream tips, streamtips.com/t/SwissDC_EN. It's also in the panel underneath at our Twitch. Just go there, donate. 75% goes to the charity, 25% goes into the prize pool for the winning team. You can also just go to Save the Children's website, easilysavethechildren.org. We also have it in the panel. And you can just go there and also donate to them straight away. And, well, having all of that said, guys, make sure to do that. We have pop-ups everywhere. If you donate, we'll show it on the stream. We have a rewards system as well. And I've been able to see the first few picks here and bans from both sides. 10 seconds remaining. Severe TV really, really, well, scared against the Meepo. Excalibur is a well-known Meepo player, and well, they're not gonna give him his hero. They're gonna ban it out in the first phase, just like all the times before. They also ban out Seraphine, pretty common ban in that sense. They do pick up the Winter Wyvern and the Earthshaker in the first phase for themselves. Earthshaker all around support, same goes for the Winter Wyvern. You're able to roam around a lot with these supports, so if you pick independent lanes, who can just be on their own, you can really do a lot with it and just go all around the map. Then second phase, they ban out the Ember, TA, just strong heroes all around. TA picked up pretty often as well. I think they still have the first game in their mind where, well, Excalibur on the TA just went crazy, so. No, just taking it out. It's okay. It's normal. It's good. I like it. Pretty understandable as well. 10 seconds remaining. As then they pick up the Queen of Pain and Slardar. So Quap is gonna be the mid laner. It's gonna be played by Fogo again. Played a pretty good Quap last game. Went for a little bit of an unusual build, going Aghanim's into Octarine Core, followed up by the Shivas. Not something you see every day. At least not Octarine Core. But it really worked out that game. You have this low cooldowns on all of your spells then. So. Those work out really nicely. Pick up Slardar as well. They don't really have a lot of physical damage right now to really, you know, take it with it. We'll open up an early Roshan possibility as well, though. For now, Logic Gaming, they ban out the Wisp, Doom, a Tusk, a Dazzle, and then a Treant. Showcasing that they want to go and push on the side here with no Logic, and their picks really showing it. Darkseer, which Darkseer maybe not too much, though. Like, Darkseer is just a strong laner. You can pick him whenever you really want to. Witch Doctor is just a strong support. When if you can get this ultimate up for a long time, it's just going to be so devastating. Terracopter is already showcasing, you know, maybe we want to go fight a bit more. And then the DK is like, okay, we're going to fight and push. We're going to be working around their the big ultimates though. Like no Elder Dragon form, no pushing, so. As they actually have a Radiant team pick. They can pick up the Darkseer here, but the Disruptor, but they actually go for Chen. Okay, I was not expecting it. I didn't know Spartan or Milan could even play the Chen. Oh my god, I have not seen NLG play any Chens. This really actually surprises me. Like, when you go pushing with, like, a Chen just does so much. It does leave your lanes a bit weak. Meaning that the Winter Wyvern and the Earthshaker can do whatever they really want. Rotation wise, and they just need to pick up a strong laner that can. That's okay against Darkseid. Might just be able to punish this. 5 seconds remaining. But yeah, no Logic Gaming. Have they ever really played the Chen though? Let's just take a quick look here. They have never played Chen as a team formation. So that surprises me a bit that they pick it up here. We'll see how they do with it. Let's see. Does Milan on Spartan ever replayed? Actually, the Husker got through against the Gyrocopter. This is a really strong pick in that sense. But the thing is, they do have, of course, the Death Ward from Witch Doctor that can deal with him, and the physical damage is there as well from the side of No Logic Gambit in the beginning. Man, they need to address this Husker fast. Like, they need to find some kind of way to really punish him. But the lanes that they're going to have currently, it's not going to work out. So Spartan, okay, Spartan has a lot of enigma behind his name and a couple of chances, just 9 games of which he has won 4, lost 5. So not the biggest of experience with the Chen, but he has played a couple of times. Let's see how it does here. I do like the overall synergy just throughout the entire draft. It's all just set on just pushing and going for kills.
5 seconds remaining.
Okay, and with everything said and done here, we see a heart coming up. Is it a broken heart or no more? No, it's a normal heart. Some love coming out from Spartan. In our game 3 here, in the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament. Between Severo TV and No Logic Gaming, it's 1 against 1. The winner will go through, will go to the semi-final here. Who they will be facing up against Team Bad English. And the team that's going to be pushed down is going to be playing up against Enzo. Or is it Edie? I think it's going to be Edie. I think it's going to be against Eternal Envy's Disciples. As we have an early GG call by Milan. Gonna annoy him. Gonna go with it. Both teams are really just having fun here with the tournament. It's all fine. Yeah, we have 3-2 viewers here. So maybe something here. Maybe something to do with that. Who knows? As I want to remind everybody as well, this is a charity tournament for Save the Children. You see them here in the bottom right now. Really go to them and just donate. It will really help out the children and would just make my day as well. If you donate straight to the website or to our stream tips, go to the panels underneath. Go there. Stream tips are showing up on the screen. So, just so you know. How long can they impass? I need to go. apparently Mitch has to educate his girlfriend on what it is. Oh my god, these guys are just making it impossible to do it. Yes, I'm like, what are they gonna do with this? I'm really surprised I actually picked it up, like Spartan doesn't play too often. But at least like it's a global synergy that they have with their draft to just to be able to push. Just go there all the time. Oh, yo, yo. Oh my god, Scott. Oh my god, how the hell can I can't just take these guys serious? Okay, we're gonna go into the game. Everybody seems to be ready as Milan is. Or me just come back, one of these two idiots. Oh my god, this is the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament. Oh Jesus Christ. For who was wrong? What's wrong, buddy? You don't want to play the Queen of Pain? Swap heroes. Okay, sorry, Blacklight, I really can't read German that well. Echt wel een zielig. You're gonna donate then and then... Rose Traumwunschen? I don't know what the hell is the last. I'm not too good in German. Should take it off my resume that I'm able to speak it. Or at least read it. Not my strongest language. That's it. Are they typing in Russian? Come on, Kwepe. I know you're German. Don't try to act like something you're not. Yeah, Milan, he's asking the important question in life. When will they resume? 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, it seems like Severity V is completely ready. And we'll go into the game here after some pauses in the beginning. And we'll go in. At least Huskar has been able to take his shit, so Subark is already on the Huskar. Kwepe is ready on the Earthshaker. Luft on the Slaughter. Foe again on the Queen of Pain and a moment. I think did he play Winter Wyvern all three games? I'm not completely sure, but he did play the previous one. For NLG, Milan's gonna be playing the Witch Doctor. Spartan's gonna be playing the Chen. Madara is gonna be playing the Dragon Knight. Leaving Excalibur on the mid. The Aerocopter? Okay. And Mitch is gonna be the Darkseer. Walking on top, not contested at all. It seems that Severa want to do like this wraparound and catch them off guard, but you're not gonna find anyone, as the entirety of NLG is already back here. Actually, if Madara walks like this, he's gonna be found out. He's walking in, they see him. Fissure's ready. Oh yeah! Madara is gonna get it, he's gonna eat it all and he's gonna die. Kill for Luft. Yeah, almost Milan, almost. They're at least able to still pick up the bottom rune here for NLG. What are they gonna give it to? Milan? Excalibur? Who the hell is gonna take this rune? And someone needs to take it or Luft might just see it here. I think he sees it. Yeah, he sees it. Milan needs to pick it up. He just wants to taunt him a bit. Show him that he can just take it like that. Forcing Luft to take the long way back as well. To lane. Okay, they are gonna send up Madara here in mid against the Queen of Pain here in the end. Wondering how he will do as it's against somebody against range and he doesn't really have a favorable matchup there. Same time. I don't think Huskar is too happy about the constant arrest coming out from the Iron Shells either, so. That's a trade-off in the end. Oh, they're gonna go for Luft. Rock and Barrage is gonna be there. Coconut is nothing to bounce to as Luft will be able to escape. Meantime, here in middle, they're able to pick up Madara. Rotation came in here from Kwepe, and with that, they were able to pick up the kill. At least, you know, the good thing about having the Winter Wyvern here on the top lane against the Darkseer is that you're at least able to constantly spam out Golden Brace, healing up the core while he's taking farm. Seems like Kwepe is looking for an initiation angle here with Fissure. If he can block up Mitch here, he's not able to get out. Oh, he's walking forward! But yeah, he's already back in time. Spider senses were tingling a bit too much over there. As Luft, not really having the most of fun against Milan here. Running back in. Seems to be wanting to go for the rune here, but... Yeah, Spartan seems to be able to not... Yes, he's denying the rune straight in front of Luft. He has one nuke, but I don't think it's going to be enough. And he's not even able to cast it off. Did they max it a bit? I believe so. It's something with it. 100 damage. Yeah, he needs a bit more. At max 100... After, of course, magic resistance is going to be about like 75, so essentially it's going to be somewhere between 40 and 75 damage, and it's not going to be enough to kill off the Slaughter there, so he just goes back to the jungle. He can just go and take over all of the creeps one by one here. That's a Wildling Ripper, so I might be looking for some early stacks for himself there. As the Fissure actually came out on Madara, he's going to be stuck again, are they able to pick up the kill here? Kwepe also starts hitting away at him, and he will actually pick up the kill as well. Already 3 kills here for the side of Severity V, and No Logic Gaming seems to be having some trouble getting itself on the board. Sparta might have to do something with maybe a smoke. Maybe buy it soon. At least Mitch is able to get up his soul ring for now. Astounding mid here with this golden brace. Keep on following him, keep on hitting him. But Mitch in the end will always win this this duel. Spartan not really able to build into something too fancy just yet, has to buy wards as well as smokes. Pretty sure this equip here, but at least they're able to do the bottle trade. So giving him some more. Super going for the fancy wraparound on Mitch. Really has to take the damage from the burning spears, not from the from the hits itself, as pretty much everything got a proc from associate. At least Lupt is able to steal some of the experience here. If he actually killed the... Okay, Spartan. It's gonna net him up. First comes out, and in the end, Lupt has been able to pick up the bounty rune here. And will escape. At least Excalibur is having a good old time here. Already 22 CS up. Again, with 10 denies as well, so... It will hurt Lupt quite a bit. He's only level 2 at the moment. Maybe if he gets some experience here, he's able to get level 3. Oh, if he crushes here, he's gonna get it! And he actually took a lot of there. Nice play by him. His first CS of the game is straight up 70 gold. Yeah, Madara really can just stay here for with the DD, Sonic Wave, and Weppy here as well. His Fissure is anticipating and will actually block it. Madara here as well. Spartan is there trying to help out his teammate as well, but it seems like they're just gonna leave Quepa here now to die. Fohu needs to do something to help him out. Has a Sonic Wave. Spartan. Oh! He's just gonna hit Madara here. We'll force him back. Does he have a blink? Not enough mana for now. Madara is also regenerating up pretty nicely. Milan comes in, but they're not able to get off. Paralyzing cast to keep him there. It's gonna blink out for now. Mitch still really getting a lot of farm at the moment. 20 CS for him. Also a lot of experience, already up to level 5, almost level 6. Really important to get these early levels up on your darks here. Will just make your 10 to 15 minute mark so much easier. Luft has to use the paralyzing cast there, but at least it doesn't bounce to anything, so he's able to just stay there, don't die. Has been having the need to play fairly defensively. Cooldown is going to be up pretty soon on Excalibur here. Luft. They don't see Luft, but Luft doesn't see them either. And now they walk around. Mango's pop. Oh, Luft tried to do an anticipating crush there, but it completely whiffed. Now, Fohu has been able to rotate in. Excalibur needs to TP out, he's running, he's retaining up, but he is going to be able to make it. On just a slimmer of HP, he gets back to the base. Oh, Madara. They're trying to go for a teamfight here. And they're going to find Luffy just level 4, but they will get a kill. Fissure comes out from Quepe. But not really able to follow it up anything else. What's Spartan doing? Is he going for some aggressive jungling here, maybe? Or did I see him? I don't think so. And they find him, Spartan. Getting in some... A little bit of harassment, but it doesn't really matter. Quepe even gets the bounty rune. Madara with an empty bottle. Elder Dragon format for another 10 seconds. Spartan, yeah, he went for a stroll through the enemy jungle. He's gonna feed away his trolls, or trolls, his centaurs here as well. Getting off a lot of stunt though. Seems like they're just gonna leave this one for now. Madara doesn't have his Elder Dragon form anymore, so... He will be forced to play a little bit more safely here, as top lane has also been pushed in. Oh, the Splinter Blast, it's level 5? Yeah, I thought so. Level 3 already. Cooldown's gonna hit him. Needs some more. Crush is gonna connect now on Excalibur as well. Minon walks in from the back. Gets off the coconut here, start bouncing around. They need some lucky bounces, and they seem to be able to get them. As now, Luft is getting low. He's just 30 HP, they need one hit on him. Excalibur doesn't really want to go underneath the tower here. They're going to get the TP rotation in now as well. It's going to be the Queen of Pain foe who needs to blink towards the tier 2 to find the Excalibur here. That should be able to do so as the Vision actually comes out from Crappe to kill him off. 3 kills already up on him. 1k gold. Seems to be a soul ring with his tranquils. Spartan still needs to get any kind of significant items. It's 8.5 minutes in. Has boots and the apartment, but really nothing else to call interesting. Oh, what? Fosu, I think he just got baited underneath the tower here and he just gets blown up. Nice has a play there from the two of them coordinating that and just getting the kill there on foe. I really need to stop him. Colin's not gonna connect Luftis too fast here with the sprint. Pretty common build. 2-3. There's maybe an NLG are looking to go for the tower again, but there's already TP in for my moment. They just really don't want to give up this tower this early for from Severa. Oscar's pretty much alone at all times, and he has been able to CS pretty nicely though. Oh, they're going in mid. Actually, Spartan was able to pick up a kill, but now Foo just blinks over the fissure and goes for him. Madeira, this is not the fight that you're gonna win. He needs to Dragon Tail and start running away with the steel between his legs. And he should be able to survive now as Foo is not gonna be in time.
Dire's bottom tower has been denied.
Oh, they get 2 kills here. Actually kill off Milan as well as Excalibur on the gyrocopter there. I was not expecting that one there. Did they use the curse for it? They didn't even use the curse, so they dove underneath the tower and destroyed it, I guess. No, it was even denied, so it's all in the favor there for Severa. Getting 2 kills as well as denying the tower. Okay, invisibility room found here by Foo. Seems like they want to go for Mitch. Is Mitch going to be heads up and already going back? Mitch just spotted. There comes the Vizier. Yeah, he's dead. Over to say about that. Walked in aggressive and just got fissured up. I don't see Foo yet, and I see him now. So, NLG, just go back to the tower here and leave it for what it is. Spartan, is he gonna go for a fast map? Oh, he's 1.3k gold. He needs to spend his money if he dies here. It's gonna be a fast mecha for him, or maybe opting to go back for the arcades and start a picks up a solo kill on Milan here. Amplify damage is up on him, so he starts doing a lot of damage. And Madeira, he walked aggressively forward. He's gonna get fissured up and Chen Totem as well, and he will most likely die. He actually posted Dragon Tail here. And it's gonna be immediately put on cooldown. That means that 2 minutes without Dragon Tail when he comes back. Or when he comes back, it's pretty much just 1.5 minute left, but still, you get the idea. I think they thought they were able to maybe turn around with that, but it's in the end, it just didn't work out. Oh, they jump on Mitch, but not able to connect with the Fissure, so. Okay, Sparta, 1.5k gold, almost 1.6, what's he gonna go for? He really needs to buy something, right? Okay, he's gonna get a buckler, so he's gonna be the mecha carrier for his team. Meaning that Mitch can go for something else if he wants to. Maybe go for an early blink or maybe even a glimmer. That's the magical damage coming out from Severe is pretty big. That said, they do have an amplified damage, so using it for saving is going to be a bit troublesome. It could be a possibility, maybe 4 staff or it's also something that could be a good potential item for him. Or just finish up his magic one. Seems to be flats for Excalibur. Really itemizing to go for an early push. That of course gives now lifesteal to ranged heroes as well, so.
Top tower is under attack.
Really nice to just pick up on one's range course if you can or if you need to, so.
Radiant's middle tower
would have maybe preferred attack to see it on the Darkseer though. over Excalibur, and then we can just go maybe go for Sun Jar Shao or an early BKB or someone along those lines. HUD. But we don't know, of course, yet, but I'm just assuming it. Seem to be willing to trade towers. I know G pushed it a bit faster, but tower in mid will eventually also go down. They have a smoke ready on a moment? No? Did Quabby pick it up? Quabby pick it up. Luft, you can't really go for Excalibur here, so just indeed stay back. Again, this game as well. Vohu is getting a lot of farm. Seems to be going for Milan here. This paralyzer, I guess, has nothing to bounce to. Is he gonna commit the Sonic Wave for this? Oh, there comes out the Death Warp bouncing to. Oh, the Fissure doesn't connect. They should know by now where Milan is, but he is pretty well hidden here. They will get him in the end, but not without him doing a lot of damage and them getting a return kill here on Vohu. As well as on Quepe. Now, a moment, just TP the hell out of there. Luft has been able to already pick up his Blink Dagger for an offline Blink Dagger pre 40 minute blinks. That's pretty nice. He already has another 500 gold up there as well. Dire structures are fortified. Seem to be willing to defend the tier 1 here. They have a Blink. They're going to connect on 2 here. Nice crush coming out. And now Life Break is going to be a use on Madara, but he's just going to use his Dragon Tail and starts running away. But with him running his way, he's going to make it. 1 second left, he is going to be able to get back to base, but the damage is going to be real. Is he going to survive through? What? He's actually walking out of the base? Oh, doesn't matter too much, he died anyway with the 8 stacks up of him. It was just too much. And now the creeps from Chen are going to be farmed up as well. Overall, nice win there for Severe to be able to keep the tier 1 as well, get 1 kill as well as a bunch of Shank creeps next to it. Excalibur, he's gonna look for something here. Milan's there as well. And they just come out of invisibility with Rocket Barrage on. Cooldown's gonna be used in a moment as well. They're gonna try and get him out. But the cask is gonna be there, and Excalibur is able to pick up the kill in the end with the Rocket Barrage over there. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Oh, seems to be going for an Aghanim's build this time around. Oh, again, actually. Might see him go for the same build as last time. Oxygen core next. But they did block him. Milan here for a little bit. But he was able to walk around it in the end. They want to take this fight. Oh, vacuum wall. It's going to connect on 3. There comes out the death ward. Luffy is going to go down. Quepe is going to go down. No, they just have Subark left. He does have a armlet, but he's not able to really use it. And with all of these illusions, all of these summons, minions, they go for the tier 1 push. Oh, Madara went fast there. A moment is just juking a jive and seems to be able to do so. And get out safely as well. And with this NLG, they have a strong push lineup, so they might just go for another tier 2 here as well. Mecha has been completed by now on Spartan. Oh, I was gonna leave it alone for now. Madara actually went for it. A glimmer there. I was not expecting that. Scatterbird's on the front line, getting cursed up. They really want to, really want to kill him. They're popping everything, and they're gonna get a kill. They're gonna get 2 kills. As Mitch now also in the backline dies as well. Now Milan getting low. Amplify damage is up on him. All this physical damage deals too much. He's gonna use his stick, but will in the end die. Someone wants sandbank, and that's gonna be Madara. He's the only one alive. As they give up 4, while trying to push for the tier 2 here, and that was in the end an overextension. And it was just turning into a Roshana. They're not going to be abusing the Huskar trick for Roshan too much. As she will be standing over here then, pretty much. Just, you can just use your armlet, put it up. He will bash you at most once and then walk back. So you should never really die when doing that. Just a fun trick, try it out in your pubs. If you lose the game because of it, don't come complaining to me. With that, the lead for Severe TV seems to be growing bigger and bigger here. It's going to be around 3k, maybe a little bit more in both experience as gold. As if they win this game, they're going to go through into the semi-final of the winner brackets, the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament. Just want to remind everybody, this is for the charity Save the Children. We have the panels all in the underneath the Twitch channel. You can go to donate there to on our stream tip or on their website instantly. It's pretty much all self-explanatory on the in the panel. So just go there and do that.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Excalibur actually didn't go for the flat. He just went for the HUDs. More common build. I would still love to see the item. It's fun. This just gives you some ability to just go and stack your Asians, as well as have a permanent scout out in the worst pit. As maybe Spartan wants to use all of his own creeps to just go and, you know, use them in fights. He has 4 creeps up. Might want to look for a push. Oh, got a kill on top here with Excalibur with the cooldown used. Dead Dwarf as well, so they committed 2 ultimates, but they got back to slaughter for now. Seems like Excalibur wants to go for a push. He's gonna escape. Kwepe, Enchant Totem, yeah, he even stopped it. I don't think it was in range anyway. They're gonna try and look for someone, but I don't think they will find anybody as Mulan's already pretty far back. He can just TP out if he wants to. Might have to do it fairly soon. It seems like he's just gonna have some balls of steel and stay there. Spartan. Yeah. I'm back for the arcanes. Now some wards coming up. Darks actually went for the Midas here. So he just wants to make sure that he can always get some farm and is ready once late game arrives. So he should be able to probably pick up this game, refresher orb somewhere downline. Well, unless this rotation is gonna work. They're gonna go for it. Instantly pop the Echo Slam on him. They really wanted that Darkseer dead. Let's go, his HUD has an armlet, 1.6k gold. The normal build would be to buy a Sunch now into an Heaven's Halberd. You can also, of course, buy the Heaven's Halberd. What the hell was he doing there? Well, he just gets killed. He should have been with his team pushing. And he will be punished for that. Egg is going to be reclaimed in 2 minutes. It seems like Sphere TV don't really want to go into a push battle here, as Logic Gaming's push is just a little bit stronger. Fisher will keep the creeps away for now. That's a Shadow Blade on Dragonite now. Okay, that's what he used the Glimmer for. A moment also has the Glimmer complete. And Madeira is looking for someone. He's going to find Luft. And he goes instantly with the Dragon Teal, trying to blow him up, but there comes the Curse. They're gonna try and turn this one around here. Luft going strong, going pretty valiantly here as well. So they're able to get out with the Fissure there. But Super is trying to kill Skeletor. He's just TPing out, but he will die here in the end to Death Ward. It was just the Aegis Milan. Yeah, they see him, they're gonna kill him. He doesn't really see them jumping on him until it was too late. So in the end, nice raid there for Severe TV. They haven't really been able to use the Aegis tool really full to really its full potential, but at least they were able to defend their tower and go from there. They haven't been able to take the tier one, tier two in mid. Took some damage, but in the end, not gonna be that. This smoke was a bit obvious and didn't work out in the end. He's looking. He doesn't have. He has a Blinkless cooldown. That's kind of a problem. But Luft, he's just gonna go throwing the Crest, throwing Amplify. Wanna make sure where Excalibur is. It's gonna be the either the Sunch and Yasha build up for him, or we could be as to find Luft here. Madeira goes into his Elden Dragon form, but it gets featured right now. So the wave is on top of them. They don't have the Curse for now. 10 seconds. There comes out the Vacuum, connecting on two. The walls just. They just get one thing there. As now, oh, Super Arc. They need to kill him off, and they're actually able to do so with the Death Ward there popped as well. They just lose 1-for-1 in the end, but in favor of Severe TV. Oh, as now they kill Madeira. Oh! Kwepe going for the place. Gets up the Echo Slam, but now it's a run. And he will die in the end. Excalibur will start hitting his friend, Milan. And now comes out the Charisse. They're gonna start cleaning this up. At least not... Excalibur is not going down with the least staking. With him. a moment. Actually, Chant getting the double kill. It's gonna be a 4-3 trade in the end. Severe TV should be a little bit favored there. Yeah, about 800 gold and actually pretty big experience change from that. We'll further the lead a bit. Oh, Foe went in aggressive and he doesn't have the mana to get out for now. He's a little bit more seconds that he's able to bottle up and just go down. Bring it out. When will they have vision of him? Oh, they just mid-shot too late. They're able to blink out in the end here. Foe will survive. It's gonna go for Shivas now. Okay, that's gonna be a little bit different. Luft is just going for the pretty much the basic starter build. Trunkles into Blink, into 4-step, nothing really too exciting about that. Ooh. Just clicker and Subark! Yeah, what's he going for? He's an ogre. So BKB? Do you want to go BKB on this card? That's like a big question. Poor stuff seems to be the next item here for Kwepe. Yeah, Rosan's gonna take some bit more time, but I guess we're just trying to set up a bit of a trap. It's now actually Silver has just completed on Madara. We'll take him up. There's not really... Well, I guess if he uses it on this card, like, that's gonna be the prime target. Like, getting out to Bash for a couple of seconds, okay, it's nice. And Kwepe, yeah, if you can get out the Aftershock and he just then whiffs his ultimate, then sure, but realistically speaking, that's not gonna happen. It's gonna walk in out. Who is gonna be the target, it seems like. But the entirety of Severe TV is ready for this. They're standing behind him. Curse comes out on Excalibur, but Madara already has been able to split up pretty nice. Excalibur is getting low. They need to get out the Hand of God. They will do so. The Medkit comes in as well, but in the end, Excalibur will still go down. Was able to get off the cooldown before. Luft is now taking a lot of damage. Fohu is going to go down as well, as Chen just purifies him over there. 2-for-1 trade in the end in favor of NLG. Did lose Excalibur for it, but I guess for now they will take it. It's not really what you want, but sometimes you just have to accept it. Yeah, comes out the Echo Slam for Kwepe, but he's not really able to bring anybody low enough. As they're just healing up here with Milan with his Death Ward and his food restoration on. They take a lot of damage from tower there. Mitch's Vacuum was also a little bit off the mark. And now Oscar, he just strolls in. Starts popping the life break. Madara needs to hit him here just to get off this this magic resistance, and they will be able to do so. 4-staff comes out of Milan, meaning that Kwepe can't really kill him. Even search him up, that was a little bit unnecessary there. Madara will go down as Luft is able to just crush him there. Mitch will be able to get the kill there on Kwepe. Now a moment is a little bit trying to fight up against Spartan here, but with Luft taking out Milan, he's able to go back in here. Vacuum comes out. There comes the Cauldron as well. He's going to connect. A moment. 4-step forward. And he's going to die here now. Foe comes in. Does have a Sonic Wave. He's going to throw it out. The Excalibur getting low. Luft is there as well. He has a Blink in one now. So Foe goes first. And Luft is not able to connect. 4-step in. 3, 2, 1. Same time, Foe already has him killed. By blinking in his path, making sure he can't get out. Just like that, Severe TV take another big fight there, and it's gonna be a little bit in their favor, not too much, as they had to buy back, of course, on a moment there. Rochelle's not gonna be up for another minute, guys, so yeah. That sucks. Have to spend another minute, and before that, everybody on the side of NLG is gonna be back. Mitch has been able to barely escape there. And Slaughter went back for a really, really late Midas. Guess we'll see how it pans out later on. But could have maybe opted to go for a BKB. I guess they're just gearing up for the late game. As Foe. What the hell is this item build up? This doesn't have anything in common. Okay, so what's he going for? Radiant's top tower is under attack. Curse is gonna come out on Madara here in the river. They're trying to keep him down. Lightbreak goes through and Hand of God as well. There's not going to be mecha or enough food restoration saving there. Crush comes out and they're not able to channel the Death Ward for too long, but Krabber has already addicted up and he will die in the end. As there you go, 2-1-for-1. Triple kill. Actually, Foe is going crazy. He wants to get more. Excalibur has been amplified up. Mitch now walks in, but oh, the crush from Luv just too late and runs actually straight into the rocket barrage over there, but it seems like they're not going to pursue energy any further as they have some wall illusions as well as some creeps to take care of. Subark? He shouldn't die from this. That would be a little bit too iffy. How do we make sure that they're not overtaking Roshan? Let them just walk in with illusions? Oh. Still, they're doing a pretty nice amount of damage here. They don't have their... Oh, Mitch! He throws two onto the cliff, but they have a life break as well as Blink, so... They won't be staying there for too long. Baldan is there as well. They seem to be just going for a moment. He's gonna eat a lot of magical damage here. But he won't go down for now. But in the end, once the moment he's gonna be seen, these will most likely be killed. Oh, they need a bit more damage. It's not gonna be enough. Roshan is half HP and Side of Sephiroth needs to go back. They will lose a moment. As now NLG are gonna be looking to take the Roshan. There's a ward up, they see it. See them walking up. Do they even see Mitch there? Now Mitch is just hidden well enough. Can pop his arcanes. Loops goes in, but it's a bit too early. He needs to force F now out again. They will need to rely on Kwepe to get it done. Blink in right now. No, it's too late. They got it. Kwepe even wasted his ultimate because of that. Wasn't able to steal it. They tried to make the plays, but in the end, it didn't really work out. And indeed, it's gonna be a BKB here for Subark. As for what the hell is he still going for? Still wondering. It seemed like these items don't really have a lot of in common. Except they actually have nothing in common. It's either gonna be a side here or it's gonna be the Lincolns. It seems to be the Lincolns. Could still be a Lotus though, because of the plate mill. Like, we'll see what Queen of Pain is gonna build up soon. Dire's bottom tower has Bottom tower, they did lose the tower here, but they're looking for Luft. Vacuum is there, they're gonna kill him off. Very nice, same time has been able to take the tower. We're gonna look for the tier 3 right now. Group up is 5, but they will need 5 first. So they're gonna look for a solo kill here. He's waiting a bit, he has 3 more seconds. He will get it off. Oh, Subar gonna take a lot of damage. He has no physical magical resistance. He's gonna get low, he's gonna go down. Big pick off there. Milan doing the trash talks again. Oh my god. Would have been more impressive if he was the Rubik again. At least then it would be like, you know, being actually a hero that relies around doing magic damage instead of the physical damage from a Death Ward. And they're. Slowly sieging down this tier 3, just 200 HP left before the fortification got out. Oh, Madara actually missed there on the Dragon Tail. Oh, nice 4-step, they used on the Sand Tower, big play there. They're able to keep him a little bit closer. Oh, Luv just completely whiffing on his crush there. That comes out the heal of Head of God. Luv's trying to run away, he's taking a lot of damage from this Death Dwarf. The Aegis is going to be popped. Foe is going to be in the middle of all of this. The color actually doesn't really connect as he was able to blink out just in time. A moment gets off the curse. Now Skelebird is getting low. Spider is going to get killed. Subark is trying to clean this one up. They go forward. No crush used by Luft. He's just getting just disabled all the time because of the paralyzing cuts. Madara pops his BKB trying to fight up against them. He's man-moding. He seems to be winning it for now, but he's just waiting until the BKB ends. He's just going to TP out with the last nick of time on it. They get a tier 3. They get, seems to be the melee Rex, yeah, and they will pay with 4 lives in the end. Did leave Madara alive for now. Could be worse, could be better. We'll take a little bit of a drop now, but having this one lane's Rex advantage is really what NLG was going for. So they really use the Aegis now. The game will be well, doing essentially nothing for the upcoming 5 minutes until Rush is up. Yeah, Luffy's looking for Madara, but he's not gonna get him. Goes in Fizz. And we'll just run away. Even if I have a haste for his troubles. Scatter has a BKB complete. Still isn't really the biggest of farm. Even though he's like 11k up, it doesn't feel like he's that strong at the moment. He needs like a damage item now. Maybe, I guess a butterfly would make him a bit more, give him more some more effective HP as well, some damage. So maybe the item to go for depends a bit on what Subox has now. Still doesn't have any evasion, so you don't need to get an MKB just yet. And the smoke is there from NLG. Seem to be going for the tier 2 push on top. What the hell? Who plays this shit? Hey, Moment bought it, so I guess he plays it as well. I don't know, plays it like here or something. At least you get some different vision. I guess with the tower now going down, they at least still have vision there. Still a bit weird that you place it there. And NLG, they seem to be just going straight into the tier 3s again. They run up. And they just keep on force-stepping forward their creeps. This time the mode golem. A Moment is looking for a fissure here. Or a curse. Same time Crepe is looking for the big echo. Madara has to pop his BKB as he's standing here in the front. Last curse comes out in the back line. Subark is looking for a kill. Goes for a miss here. Hand of God comes out as well as the mecha. They need to keep everybody alive. But Spartan is not going to be focused by him at the same time. They're running into the base. Mitch is now in the middle of four. That is a bit of a whiff crush there. And because of that, they get out with the vacuum. And they get a kill because of it. Double buybacks are now used. Because in the back line, they were able to clean up the Huskar. They're running in. They smoked up as well. Oh my god. Luft again hitting a creep. And they're going to send back Excalibur. Milan might just be the sacrificial lamb for everybody to get back. Nope, Madara. They're still going to move up. I don't think they know exactly where he is, so he needs to go and hide into the trees, and he will be able to do so. And now he needs to wait for his Silver Rage to come off cooldown. In the end, the fight did go a bit in favor of NLG. Of course, Tower Gold isn't shown, but they get the tier 3. The melee barracks will actually be able to regen up. Darrow's running out, but Luft is really just on the still. Luckily, he doesn't see him. I think they just really gave him a heart attack over there that he guessed it. It's amplified damage on the crew. So right now, who is going to go back for the assault curves for now? It's going to build into a bit more physical core. Well, Excalibur is going to go for Taz before evasion. He's going for the butterfly. As I expected, there, Spartan. Four steps. Sivas is going to be on Mitch. I would really love to see a refresher. It's just too much fun. And I think this is going to be the first flash of the game. Yes, the first flash of the game is purchased in the end here by Slaughter. Finally been able to purchase a full item with his... because of his Midas. Has an Ogre Club now as well. Looking for a BKB. Oh, what? They just popped all of the smokes. Fohu. Looking at some troublesome here. Paralyzing Cast goes through to what too? Fohu is actually going after Spartan pretty hard here, but doesn't have his ultimate for another 25 seconds, so this is not really the fight for him to take. His Linkers will be popped soon, but. Seems like NLG aren't really able to find a nice angle to go from. We'll see when Roshan is up in 30 seconds. So. Let's see what NLG wants to do. They've really been keen on pushing all the time, but I think they should probably take a step back. They're going to build up an AC right now. And Excalibur has his butterfly complete if he wants to buy it out. Seems that he wants to do that. Shan's gonna be back in 30 seconds, so pretty quick respawn timer there. Still, Fu is doing great again. Is again top of the leaderboard here on gold. It's gonna go for another Octarine here. As his energy booster. Is he gonna see Spartan? He's seeing Spartan straight in vision. What? Okay, that was a miscue there of his skills. Madeira, he can actually Dragon Tail him now. He's gonna go for it as well. Do they have to damage there? No vision comes out. They can claim, blink out now. Okay, yeah, I was all thinking. So, Milan, this is probably a fake. So Roshan is up, but it seems like they're gonna go for the push up here. Oh, big team fight coming out. Curse comes out, but it's just locked in one. They want to kill off Mitch. Mitch, if he can get him dead before he can get off his wall, but he just goes forward. He goes for the play, but Grape comes out with the Echo Slam, killing him up together with two. It's a one for one race so far. So the Grape comes out, but it just does some damage, and they don't really have anything to follow it up with the BKBs on here. They're gonna take a step back. Silver Edge up. Dara is looking for someone, and he's gonna find Luft, but he's gonna be stunned up before he can do anything really. He needs to be forced step back to his Steve. Splinter Blast is not enough to kill him. They're getting him low. Will they actually be able to kill him off? They go even more aggressive, and they will be able to do that. Everybody's clamped up. It's gonna be a three-man crush right now, but Excalibur, he seems to be a little bit too strong. He's going hard here. This Butterfly right now is doing so much. They're not really able to get in too many hits on him. Kogu in the back. They're gonna go for Spartan right now. He seems to be the easy target. As Excalibur is now on his own, he needs to get the hell out, but he's amplified up. He's not really going to be able to get anywhere. Sonic Wave now comes out. And an ultra kill for Fohu. Well, there was a team fight. Heavily going in the way of Severa TV. They did lose the Husker in yet, but it's just the Husker, it's okay. They know Roshan is up now as well, they can amp it. There's a DD ready as well. Are they gonna be on the same page? What the hell? So I guess Quip was just carrying a random mango plus clarity, giving it to Foe here. Yeah, they're gonna do it with the two of them soon. Husker will be there as well. Ooh, Vacuum Wall comes out from Mitch, but where's it gonna be the follow-up? Milan's a bit too late. Silver Edge from Madeira. It's gonna be searched up. Roshan, in the meantime, is gonna be taken. We're gonna give it to the Husker. He has not really been feeling like this big Husker game. Like, he has not really been able to do a whole lot. His end progression has also been stalled for such a long time. He's only 10k up right now. 40 minutes in, your position 1, that's not where you want it to be. The good thing is, it's this Queen of Pain, Fohu. He is pretty much. He's really, really stacked. He has an Octarine core now as well. Did buy out, so if they lose a base defense, it will go wrong. But the question is, are Energy going to be looking to push into their base? I don't think so. I think they're okay with just letting it go like this for a bit. At least until the Aegis is gone. Spartan, he's gonna go for an Aghanim's. So it's a really long way to go though. Aghanim's is up on Mitch as well actually right now. So he just want to have some stronger as well as long duration illusions. I'm not completely sure, I know. Oh yeah, it's just the damage actually. That's gonna be given out. It's pretty nice as well because you're able to seal the aura, so you're gonna get the flats as well as an AC for your team. I think I already have one AC completed. Well, they will have soon, though. Madeira doesn't have it just yet. He's going. If his needs to run out, they're going to connect on him. Need to get the jab. Oh, Quip has the jab. They're going to find him. They emptied him up pre-BKB, but he's not really able to escape from here. And he just gets bashed up all the way through. And with that, Madeira is dead for 70 seconds. He doesn't have his buyback. So even closer to the money, he tried to buy out. Bottom barracks here, melee barracks getting low. Crappy needs to get in and defend it. We'll do so as well.
Crystal blink forward. But nah, it's not gonna find Spartan here. They have four here from Severe. If he's, do they really want to push into this right now? They are missing Kwepe, who has the Echo Slam. They do have still have the Aegis. They have the Aegis for still 2 minutes. I guess they want to destroy it for now. They're going to put Subark on the front lines. Just tanking it up with his Aegis. Random Crush here on Excalibur. There comes the Vacuum Wall. The curse is going to be returned though. Straight onto Mish. Mish taking a lot of damage. Mish has just been able to survive for now, but he will die in the end. As they actually get the Husker back for now, team time. Oh, is just going for kills on the back lines. He's going to get a Spartan as well. It's going to be a double kill for him. As right now, they're 3 down on the side of No Logic Gaming. Sphere TV seems to be doing it. Kwepe has now gotten there as well. Oh, Excalibur. He got 4 steps forward. He's in the middle of all. And there comes out the Echo Slam. Madeira was also caught in the middle of this. He's going to go down as well. Instant buyback here coming out from Excalibur, but. Foe is like, hello buddy, but he is missing so many hits here because of this this bit of life. Pretty much just keeping alive. Oh, what? Oh, Foe, oh, he's gonna get vacuum backed in as well. He's gonna go down here maybe. Yes, he is. He goes down. Chris misses from Luft. Seems like Severity, if you want to go for the GG push, but they will just get it to. He still didn't get the range. I think they're gonna give it a couple of pokes and go back now. Sphere TV, they got the Rex. They almost lost the range Rex though. Look at it. Pretty low. 1 in 30 now. Just. Should be refreshed for a moment. Having double curse will do so much. I would just like to see refreshers on everybody. It's just too much fun. Maybe not Husker, but apart from that. Yeah. Refresher gaming is real gaming, real man gaming. Kwepe has another 2.7k gold though. Seems that the first new investments coming out for Severity TV are gonna be BOTs. What's Subar gonna do? I didn't go for a blink, so. And I need to get this career away. Seems like after their last team fight, NLG want to go and push into mid and get another lane for themselves as well. There's still one Rex ahead, so. Scatterbury, yeah, he has just to go and tank this one up. Yeah, Madeira goes up there with Elder Dragon form. They seem to be really sure about this as the Viking Wall comes out on 3 here. And Husker keeps on walking through it and he's gonna die here. This physical damage is just too much for him, especially with the wall right now. Push that forward. Oh, there comes the Echo Slam on 3. And the Sonic Wave to follow it up. They blow up 3 here. Triple kill for Foe again here. Now Luf against Madeira. Madeira is not going to win this one as the Glimmer Capes come out. Luf is going to stay alive. And now Milan comes in. Milan's against 5 here. He's not going to win this 5-man wipe for NLG as Foe picks up. I think maybe even his third ultra kill of the game. 29-5-15 for him. He's been having a crazy game so far. Gonna go for an MKB now as well. He bought out. Doesn't have the buyback available, but they just want to go and end this game right now. Milan. Is he seen here? Yeah, he is seen. He's gonna be slowed as well. But he has to blink. He's able to get out for now. Still wanna go after him. Going really aggressive. They only have a buyback on Spartan and they use it. But what can the two supports do right now? That's gonna be the question. Well, Spartan can die. That's the obvious one. Milan's just gonna go into the base. Foe even kills up the Witch Doctor as well. And that's gonna be the GG well played. Severe TV winning their the series here against NLG. 2-1. First game. No Logic Gaming really just did what they had to do and they just won it. With their lineup really just snowballing out of control. Second game, they went with a little bit of a funky draft and Severe TV were like, okay, we'll go basic meta and win this one. And here in the third game, they are actually able to take it as well. They're going to go into the semi-final. They're going to be up against a team Bad English. Not really an easy team to be up against. As NLG are going to be knocked down to the lower brackets. And they're going to be up against Enzo.
So, with all of that said, this is the Mount Hermon Charity Tournament. This is for Save the Children. They are a charity that help refugee children all around the world. Please go to streamtip.com/d/swissisi_en and donate there. We'll put 75% to charity, 25% to the prize pool. Or just go to savethechildren.org and donate straight to their charity. And with that, today's games are over. The next game is going to be this Friday. And it's going to be a good one as well, actually. It's going to be Hail United against London Conspiracy. We have just signed up Jellybean and a Princess. I hope I say it correctly. Sorry, guys. It's going to be at 2030 CET. And with that, I hope to see you guys then. I'm @Sender_Dota.